research in psychophysiology. I'm a psychologist, but I have a PhD in psychophysiology. So I moved from the field of psychology and the study of behavior to the study of brain and its functioning and the connection between the behavior and the brain function. But I'm also an artist involved in several projects with music and live visuals, and more or less recently, just some years ago, I tried to fuse these two parts of me, the research Enzo and the artist Enzo, trying to apply neural technologies and the study of brain to art. This is getting more simple in the recent years because technologies, neurotechnologies are becoming very cheap and they are spreading around the world. So the interest in the use of your brain as a controller, as an art instrument, of course, aside the common reasoning and so on, that is becoming really more interesting, and there are much more people interested in how to use these new technologies to make interactive works which work at a level more direct. It may seem that it's not so, but yes, it's a very direct way of interacting with the machine. This field of study, the connection between the use of the brain to control technological machines and equipment is called brain-computer interface. And I tried to use this kind of technology, this kind of techniques, to control my own artworks. I started in 2006, by the way, in my laboratory where I work in Rome, I found some tape cassette, like an analog tape cassette, do you remember? And I found this cassette where the EEG was recorded, because before the digital era, EEG was recorded in analog format, in like tape, analog tapes, and in the past also in vinyls. So I found these strange tapes, big tapes, which I tried to play, and I listened to the sound of the brain. And I understood one important thing, that the brain makes music sounds. You should know that our brain activity is an oscillatory activity. It's like sound. It moves up and down very quickly in time. So I decided to transform the brain activity in raw sound. My first work that I made together with a friend and colleague, a dear friend of mine, which is Mattia Casalegno, was called Sounds of Complexity, because our goal was to try to show in a comprehensible way how the brain works and how it's complex. And Sounds of Complexity was born. Sounds of Complexity was first performed in Rome in 2006, maybe. And we had a good success with this kind of audio performance. I just want to make you listen to the sound of the brain. Our goal was to render visible invisible forces, because this happens in our brain. And the good thing is that you could, if the frequency was higher, you could also listen the sound of your own brain. So you should know that at the neuron level we are a little bit digital, because the neuron is used to discharge or not discharge. There are no intermediate levels. Well, in other levels of brain functioning, there are of course many intermediate levels, but not at the electric level of the brain. The neuron is able to discharge or not to discharge. So we started a reasoning about the digital nature, in some extent, of the brain function. And this was a suggestion, a very strong suggestion for us. Sure. So it's just a question. Electricity, waves, sound. Because sound is just an oscillation. And brain frequencies, brain waves, are oscillations. So why not to use it as audio material? As you can see, the most part of the frequencies are concentrated under the 20-30 Hz. This is a fortune, because if not, we should start to listen our brain. And this could be a little bit disturbing. And we should know that also that the brain signal is a very, you have heard, is a very noisy signal, because all the frequencies are melded together. When we record brain waves, we must separate these frequencies, these brain waves. And this is what we did. The other thing that we did was to shift these very low frequencies to the audible range. So that, for example, 10 Hz, which is the alpha rhythm, was moved to 50 Hz, so a big sub bass. And high frequencies to very, very high audible frequencies, like around 3,000, 4,000 Hz. And we were able to listen all the complexity of the brain, all these dynamics going on at the same time in parallel. Then we started to visualize the sounds, and we found that VVVV is a very good way to visualize the sound in this case, because we started from the sound of the brain. And we did some visualization based on brainwaves, and also based on the raw EEG signal, just the EEG track, like this one, for example. This one is the rendering of 1 second of EEG. You may know that the brain is very quick, very, very, very quick, as a light speed, maybe. So this is not perceived in our life, but if you try to project this complexity in images, you may get aware that the complexity is inside us, of course. And this kind of images speaks by themselves, because you see that only 1 second of EEG, 1 second of brain activity, contains millions and millions and billions of neurons activated and frequencies going. How to make this complexity understandable by the people? By images and by sounds, of course, which is a language which the people can understand. So this was one of the first performances. It's called, of course, it's Sounds of Complexity, that we performed at the Aquario Romano in Rome, where we used the recording of my brain, and we show it in a very large space.